In this video, we're going to make these little 3D leather Christmas tree ornaments. Now, I've got a free pattern available for this because it's only simple. If you want to get the pattern, have a look down in the video description, and there's a link there where you can go and download it. It's just a quick and simple thing, just as something to try out for Christmas. Okay, so here's the leather pattern, and this one's really simple. So all we've got is we've got three little Christmas tree pieces, and then we've got a kind of cone piece, and that's going to form the tree stump, if you like, or the base for the tree. So the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to make a little template so we can easily cut the trees out all the same, and the same for the base here. So if you don't want to make the template, I've put all the tree pieces on there so you could cut them at once just off the leather if you want, but I'm going to do a few of these, so I'm going to cut myself a template first. So the way that I'm going to do that is I'm going to stick these pieces to this cardboard. This is 1mm mountain board. This is what I use for making cardboard templates. It's reasonably thick and stiff, which gives you a nice sturdy template, and you can use this method for any of the patterns. So I'm going to glue these on here. Okay, so once they're stuck to the cardboard, they can then be cut out along the lines to create some reusable pieces. So I'm going to cut that piece away because that's going to be dyed a different colour. So I've got a piece with some trees on there, and then I can then also mark these base pieces. So what we've got here is basically this is going to fold round into a cone shape, and then we've got a tab here which we'll use to glue that cone shape closed. So how many did I say? I was going to do four, so I need four of these as well. So again, I'll simply scratch around this piece four times. Okay, so there's my bases, and then I'm also going to cut that piece in half, so I've got two and two, because I'm going to do two one colour and two a different colour. Okay, so two bases. And then here's my trees. So the next thing that I want to do is I want to, I'm not going to call it tooling because it's not really tooling, but we're going to apply a bit of texture to these tree pieces. So I'm going to take a sponge and some water, and I'm just going to case this leather. So basically dampen it down and then let it dry slightly. And all I'm going to do is just take some texturing stamps and basically just apply so a little bit of texture to it, so no, it's not a completely flat piece of leather. And you don't have to do this, you could just have it, you know, obviously plating up, it's going to end up like plain green leather, but I thought it might look nice if it had a little bit of slightly tree-like texture to it. So I'll just dampen that down with a sponge. It's only thin leather and we're only doing a little bit of texture, so it doesn't need to be soaking or anything like that. You certainly don't need to be messing about leaving it in a fridge for 3 days or anything like that. Just dampen it. And what we'll do is we'll leave that for about 5 minutes until the moisture starts to soak in, starts to come back to the normal leather colour, and then we can do the stamping. Okay, that's starting to dry out now, so I'll tap these in. So I've got various little stamps that you could use for this. This one's a, can't read it, E294, should you want to look it up. And it's just like a, put on that bit. It's just like a kind of, I think it's what they call a foliage type stamp. So I'm just going to go around with that and add a little bit to these trees. So basically just that kind of a thing. So just randomly going around, twisting it a little bit as you go. I'm not going right up to the edges if I can help it, so we're going to have to stitch around these edges. It's only going to make it a bit fiddlier if it's covered in pattern. It doesn't matter if you go over the edge. So I'm going to do that now on all these trees here, and then we can actually dye the pieces. Alright, that's my tree bits textured. I'm not going to do any design on the bases for these, I don't think, but you could do if you wanted. If you've got some of the acrylic paints, you know, there's nothing to stop you actually doing little, you know, painted designs and things like that if you want to. But I think I'll just keep the bases plain for mine on these. Obviously, you've got scope to do whatever decoration you want. I mean, with these, you know, you can. We're going to do some extra bits of decoration, but you can do whatever decoration you like on your trees, really. Okay, so let's get this dyed up. So I'm going to dye, obviously, the tree bits green. The bases, I think what I'll do is I'll do a couple brown to look like kind of little tree stumps, and then I'll do a couple red to look like sort of Christmas tree pots, and then you can see, you know, when you look which one you fancy, or do a different colour if you want to. Okay, so the green dye that I've got is this emerald green. It's the Eco Flow dye that Tandy do. To be honest, I never really normally use these kind of dyes. But I do have a couple of sort of, you know, more extravagant colours in them. I've done green leather projects now and again, but just, no, got that everywhere. Just not very often, but obviously for something like this, it's a little bit different to doing a, you know, a normal type of a thing. So I maybe could have sponged this actually with the size of it, but we'll just go with the dauber. And it doesn't need to be really even or anything, because obviously trees don't look even anyway. So it doesn't matter if it comes out a bit patchy. It'll actually add to the effect, really. So don't worry about getting it completely flat green. And that looks quite dark now, but of course it's going to soak in and go to a much lighter colour. And then let's dye these base pieces. Okay, so one red, one brown. Okay, so for red, I've got a Phoebin's oil dye in red, which again doesn't get used very often, but now and again. So let's do one of these red. And then for the brown one, I think I'll just use Phoebin's dark brown oil dye. It's supposed to be like a tree trunk. It wants to be reasonably dark, I suppose. And I'm just going to use that red dauber as well, because it's not going to matter if that gets a red tinge to it. Okay, there we go. So we can let these dyes dry now, and then we can come back, we can put some treatment on, and then we can start to actually cut the pieces out and construct the little trees. Alright, this dye's had a little bit of time to dry, so the next thing we can do is buff it, as usual, just to get rid of any surface pigment that's left. So we'll take a soft cloth and just vigorously give it a rub. And then once we've buffed that, we can apply a surface finish. Now, the best thing that's going to be to apply to this is just some Canorba cream. It's obviously not going outside. We don't have any of those concerns that we have with, you know, outdoor type items or anything. It's just a little indoor decoration. So some simple Canorba cream will polish this up and give it a nice shine. So to apply this, I'm simply going to squeeze some out of my bottle onto an old t-shirt. And I'm going to rub it in loosely first. So I'm just working it over the surface of the pieces. Then once we've got that coated over, I'll go to a cleaner part of the cloth and we'll actually then essentially activate the polish. So we're going to go rub this quite vigorously. That's going to build up a little bit of heat and start to work that into the surface and polish the leather. And you'll know you're doing this right when you start to see a kind of shine appear on the surface of the leather. That's the polishing the leather. Okay, so I don't know if you're able to see the difference there. You can see this red one that hasn't been done is more dull, and that's more of a shiny appearance. So I'll do the red piece and the green piece now as well, the same way. Okay, so we've got the pieces of leather now. They've all been dyed, marked out, buffed and polished with the Canorba cream. So what we're ready to do now is to actually cut the parts out and turn these into some little Christmas trees. Okay, so for the purposes of the video, I think I'll do one of the brown ones. And we'll just concentrate on one of these now so you can see it going together, and then I can make the other ones. So the next job will be to actually cut out the parts. So I'll just roughly cut, first of all, one of the pieces out. I think we'll use that one there. And then we'll cut all these pieces carefully out that we need. So to do the straight lines, I'm going to use a metal ruler and a rotary cutter. It's only thin leather, so it's very easy to go through with a rotary cutter. And then to do this little notch section, I'm just going to use a sharp Stanley knife. I'll come to that curve in a second. So I need three of my tree pieces. So again, we'll rough cut these out first. That's always a good idea, because if you leave multiple pieces on one piece like this and then start to cut one piece out, what you'll find is you'll usually go and cut into another piece by accident if you're not concentrating. So it's worthwhile just separating each piece, and then you can eliminate that risk. Okay, so we've got the three Christmas tree pieces, so these will need to be carefully cut out. We're going to have to match all these edges up, so we need to make sure we cut them carefully, otherwise we'll struggle to glue them together neatly. Okay, so there's one little Christmas tree, so I need to cut out three of those just the same. Okay, there's my pieces cut out. So I've got my three little trees and I've got my tree stump. And these trees should basically be, you know, pretty much exactly the same in order for them to line up properly. But it's only a bit of fun, this, so don't worry about it if it's not exact. Okay, so what we're going to do now is we're going to start to put this together. But before I do that, we're going to add some baubles to the tree. And what we're going to do for that is we're going to use some little brass and nickel rivets, little tiny ones, and they're going to basically look like little gold and silver baubles. So what I'm going to do is, in each of my tree pieces, I'm going to punch probably two or three randomly spaced little holes. We don't want them too close to the edge because we're going to need to stitch. So I'm just going to space around the middle, something like that. So I'll do three on there, two on there, and maybe three on there, something like that. So then I'm going to take these small sized rivets and I'll do sort of some brass ones and some silver ones to mix them up on each side. So we'll just pop the base through the back like that, pop the front on, and then on an anvil or on a hard surface, I'm going to use a little rivet setting tool and I'm just going to hammer that down. Okay, so we'll do a brass one as well, and then that should look kind of like a gold colour. You're going to have to hammer these down quite far because they're obviously, it's only very thin leather, so there's quite a lot of post. You could start trimming the posts down if you want to, but it doesn't really matter for a Christmas tree. Okay, so there's a gold one and a silver one, and I'll just do the same on the other pieces now as well. Alright, there's a little baubles hung on the tree. So the next thing we'll do is we'll put this base together. So the base is basically kind of a cone when we fold it round, which is going to give us a sort of round base to sit it on. And then what we've got here is we've got a little tab, and we're going to fold this around, and then we're going to glue that tab underneath. So what we want to do is just manipulate this into shape first. So we're just going to dampen where the tab is on the front and the back. You can see, because this is only thin leather, that dye's actually bled through to the inside there. Didn't dye both sides because you're not going to see the inside of this, so it doesn't matter. But you could do if you wanted. Okay, so we'll flip that upside down. We'll place a ruler along the length of the tab there, and we'll just bend that up like this. And then what we're going to do is we're going to fold this leather around and we're going to stick where the tab is there, we're going to stick that to the other side like this. So first of all, we're just going to bend and manipulate this into shape. So first of all, once this is glued together, obviously we don't really want to leave it just with glue. I mean, it's only a Christmas decoration, so it's probably going to be absolutely fine, but I would prefer to have something just to stop it trying to unravel. We're not going to be able to stitch through this very easily because it's to the inside, but what we can do is we can add just a little stitch at the bottom there where we'll be able to get to. So what I will do is, where this is going to wrap around and come over the tab, just here, I'll add just a few stitches which we can bind through to the inside. So just four stitches like that, that'll be fine. We'll be able to poke those through. Then where the tab is, we're going to want to rough that to help the glue stick. Now if you don't have a roughing tool, you can also just use some sandpaper. I've got a roughing tool here, so I'm just going to scratch the top of the tab there, just to give something for the glue to stick to. And then we're going to glue this into position. So I'm going to apply some glue to the top of the tab there. And then it's going to come round and it's going to stick to the inside. So I'm also going to apply some glue up the inside here. And then while the glue's drying, I'm also just going to put just a little bit of water just up the inside of this, just to help it fold round into that cone shape. And it's only thin leather, so it doesn't need much. I'm just going to dampen slightly the inside there. Now I'll just help that come around. So let that glue sit for a second. Okay, then we can fold this into shape. So we're going to fold around this part here, and we're going to stick it on top of that part there where the tab is. And being a weird cone shape, which isn't something we normally really make in leather, that's going to be slightly awkward. But because we've dampened this tab look, it's going to help us fold it over, get everything lined up. So I'm going to start to bring it round. Try and kind of get the shape half folded before we even stick any glue, just to make it less awkward. And then once we're nearly there, look, I'm going to bring this around. I'm going to make sure the bottom lines up nicely because we want it to stand neatly. And then I'm going to simply fold this tab underneath here up towards the top. Like that. And then once it's stuck, just make sure it looks like it's going to sit neatly. So it should be sat on the desk or the table all the way around so that it makes a nice solid base to stand on. If you're happy with the shape of it, it's more like a wizard's hat than a tree stump at the moment. If you're happy with the shape of it, then get your finger and thumb and then just squeeze that glue joint closed with your fingers. You can't really hammer it because you'd need a weird cone-shaped thing to hammer it on, which we haven't got. So just squeeze, squeeze, squeeze with your finger and your thumb. Let the glue sit. At the top, it's okay if you want to just squash it a little bit on both sides like that and then bring it back to shape. Put your finger in there. And there we are. That's going to be our tree stump. So we'll sew that closed later on. For now, we'll let that just sit and let the glue dry. And then we can come back to our Christmas tree pieces. All right, so we need to turn these three flat bits of Christmas tree into a 3D Christmas tree. So what we're going to do is we're going to mark a stitch line down the left-hand side of each piece. And then when we put them together, essentially, the left-hand side of that one will join to this one here. The left-hand side of that one will join to this one here. And then we'll close it up so that we'll get a kind of like a triangle shape like that. We'll take some dividers. And we want a very, very shallow stitch line, really, because it's only a little item and we don't want to be far at all from the edge where we come in here. So I don't think we want to be much more than probably 3 millimeters. Yeah, that's 3 millimeters. I think that'll be about right. So as I say, down the left hand side of each one, we'll mark a stitching line. And what you're going to need to do is kind of come up the branches. Like that. And then we're going to have to kind of manually just continue the line and join it up like that, because your wing divider is not going to really fit into that shape. So continue it up so that you're the same distance from the edge everywhere and join in the kind of zigzag bits like that. Okay, so I'll do that on all three pieces now. Okay, so the left-hand side and left-hand side have got a stitch mark on. So I'll put one piece to one side for now. And what we'll do then is we'll turn the middle piece upside down. We'll put this piece on top of it. And the first edge is going to be easier to do because it's going to be kind of flat. Then it's going to get tricky because it's going to go into a funny 3D shape. So what we're going to do is stick these left-hand edges together, which will be those two inside edges. And again, don't worry if these don't match up exactly, because we're going to kind of daub some extra green dye on these once they're all stitched, so it doesn't matter, it doesn't need to be perfect. Okay, when the glue's ready, we can stick these together. So what we want to do is align that edge as accurately and as carefully as we can. So I'll start at the little tree top. And it'll come down the branch and we'll just, it's going to line up as accurately as it lines up basically. It might not be perfect. Try and keep the edges together as much as you can and get all the points to meet like that look. And you might as well hammer this down if you can while it's flat, because you've got the opportunity to do that on that one side at least. And then if you need to, if there's any overhang look like that, you can just nip those out so that you get it more aligned. Could also use a little scalpel just to carefully trim like that to get the edge a little bit straighter if you need to. And that should be okay. Okay, so that we've got the edge all aligned. So what we'll do now is we'll stitch down this edge. So when we start the stitching, we don't want to come really right the way up to the top there, because what we're going to end up doing is trying to get three little treetop pieces, if you like, to meet in the middle there. And if we stitch right up to the top, we're not really going to get this side in. What we're going to have to do there is let that open up slightly so that it kind of, we get 3 points meeting at the top. So we'll want to stitch a little bit further down than that. So what I would say is at the top of your stitching line is you want to leave, 5-6 millimeters, something like that, and then start from about there. And what you want to do is use probably the smallest stitching iron or wheel or whatever you're using that you've got. So we'll stick with this one, which is about 9 stitches per inch. So I'll come down to about here. And I'll just get these marked in first. Okay, so there's the stitching line, you can see. So it doesn't go quite the way up to the top there. It starts slightly down. That's just going to let the top open. And then we zigzag the way down the side of the tree, down to the bottom there. So what I'll do now is I'll punch this right the way through, and then I'll stitch this down. And I'm obviously not going to show you stitching in this video because it's only quick. I've got big long videos about stitching if you want to learn actually about leather stitching. So I'll get this stitched up now, and then we'll come back and we'll put in the next side piece. Okay, there's the first little bit of stitching done down there, and the thread colour I've used, just in case anyone wants to know, is Fiochinois Vert Clair thread, which is a little bit posh for this, but it's a nice green colour to go with the green tree. So, we've got two tree pieces joined together now, which forms kind of two sides of our little tree triangle, if you like. So what we need to do now is we need to get the next one. You could as well, if you wanted to make a kind of flat tree or a tree ornament or something, you know, instead of trying to make this 3D and stand up, you could just kind of stitch two of these together and make a flat piece and, you know, make it more like a hanging, you know, hanging ornament for a tree. You could do that if you wanted, it'd work just the same. So this is going to start to get more difficult now because it's not going to be flat anymore. So what we need to do is we need to try and get this piece now glued into the existing piece that we've just done there, like that. So we're going to glue the left hand side there and the left hand side there. So just the same as before, I'm going to apply some glue. And then some glue up the inside here. Okay, let's see if we can glue this one in then. I think this time I'll start at the bottom, then we can work up towards the top, because I say the top's going to be a little bit tricky. So I'll come to the points there, look. And just work that together. And again, I'm going to do it as accurately as I can, but I'll just trim it a little bit like we did on the other side if I need to. I'll try and keep the edge together at least. Try and get the points to match as well as I can, and then this tree point here is just going to kind of come up together. So what I probably need to do now is actually tease that apart a little bit, tease that glue apart, look, and then that can just be sort of folded up and in like that. Again, I'll do my best to tap that on the edge of my marble by laying it over the edge. So we need to do the same thing now with these edges, now that they're stuck down. I need to see if I need to do any kind of trimming. Now those ones have gone together quite well actually, but you need to just shave a little bit off like that, you can do. Okay, so then I can do the same thing with the stitches now. I can mark these down, push it into shape like that, look, and it'll still sit flat enough to punch the stitches through. So let me get that bit done now. Okay, I've got two sides stitched up now, so it's starting to take its shape. And what we need to do now is obviously close it up and stitch the last side. What we also want to do is when we come to put the tree onto its stump like that, we're going to want to stitch the tree to the stump, and we're going to glue it in, but we're going to want just one little stitch just to help to join those two things together, just so in case anybody happens to pull on it thinking, oh, is that one thing or is it glued? They don't pull the top off. So what we'll have is we'll have just one little wrap stitch wrapped around to join the two pieces together. So what you want to do at this point is have a look and decide which side you want to be the back of your tree, because that's where we'll put the stitch. Now I've got like a weird stain going on the corner there. I don't quite know what's going on with that. So I'll decide that that's the back. That could be my back piece. So I'm going to slip that over there, right in the middle of the tree, which is about there. Just a little way up. All I'm going to do is just knock in a little pair of holes like that, and what we'll do is we'll all those through to the stump and we'll just wrap a stitch round a few times, literally just to nick those together. So I now know which piece I'm considering to be the back. So to finish gluing this up, obviously we've got two sides left which we want to bring together. So we just need to do exactly the same thing that we've done on the other sides here, but it's going to be even fiddlier now because it's all the same piece. So I'll try and just keep those apart for a minute so they don't try and stick prematurely. So I'll just wedge a pen in there for a second. All right, let's see if we can join this together then. So take my wedge out there. So I think what I'll do is I'll start at the top again this time, and then I'll try and form the top of the tree a little bit. As I say, that's going to be difficult because you've got sort of three pieces of leather coming together there at the point. So I'll just try and manipulate the first point down and together there, and then just try and squeeze those together a little bit just to come to a kind of point. Make sure that's all stuck nicely, and then I'll just work my way back down to the bottom, keeping the edges aligned. And back down there. Okay, so that's that closed up. So again, I'll just try and hammer this as best I can on the edge of the marble, just to set that glue a little bit. Okay, so we can really start to see the shape with that now. So all I'm going to do now is exactly the same as I did on the other sides. I'm first going to look and see how well it's lined up, see if I need to do any trimming. I can see that just there, for example, that comes slightly further out. So I'm just going to take a slither off there. Be careful with your fingers, obviously. Let's get that to meet there. And that looks pretty good. So I'll do the same thing again now. Mark the stitches down, stitch down the side, and then we'll come and pop it onto its tree stump. Okay, there's the tree stitched down all three sides. So we can see the shape of it now. It's looking good. So what we want to do is we want to just tidy up these edges now any further that we need to. And then we're going to die them. So just have a look down each edge and try and make sure it's as kind of even as it can be. Okay, so once you're happy that the edges are as straight as they get in, just kind of form the shape a little bit as well. You might find that these points have got a bit sort of knocked out of shape a little bit as you've been messing about doing your stitching. So just try and get them stuck out, you know, as you would expect in this sort of triangle shape. Just form that up. Don't need to be perfect again, just getting as good as we can get it. Okay, so what we can do now is we can paint in these raw edges that we've got here. So I'm just going to use the same green dye. If you happen to have a green edge paint, I suppose you could use that as well if you wanted to paint that in. I'm just going to use this same dye here. And you can use a brush, or easier, you can just use a cotton bud if you want as well. We'll use a cotton bud because I can't actually find a brush. But you could use a little, you know, very cheap little artist's brush if you want. But if we just get some on a cotton bud, this should work fine as well. Down these edges, which we've left cut now, and just tip those in with the green dye. And what I'll also do is I'll just go along the bottom edge like this as well, around each edge. Okay, so I'll finish that now, just going around the edges, and then we'll come back and we'll stitch that little stump and attach it in. Alright, let's stitch this through then, and it's going to be a bit awkward because we're stitching to the inside, so we just need to pull through on an angle. And we're literally just doing three tiny stitches in here, just to keep that together. I cannot actually bring myself to, you know, only glue something. I know it's only a Christmas ornament, but I can't in all good conscience only do glue on it. Even though that's all it is, I just can't let myself do that, so it's getting a stitch. And we'll just snip those off on the inside like that. That's all we need. It's literally just a little tack, is that, just so that if this ever gets pulled side to side, it's going to stop the whole thing unravelling. That should be absolutely fine. And this is about to disappear off up into the tree anyway. Now we need to fit these two things together. So what we're going to do is see how much we want sticking out here. And if you want, you can always trim some off the top. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to push them together first. I'm going to sort of ram it up in there and see if that looks like I've got about the right amount. So you can see that I've got kind of... how much is there? There's about 15 millimetres worth, 15, 16 millimetres worth of sort of tree stump. And that looks about right, I think. So that should be absolutely fine for me. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get some glue. And I'm going to turn this upside down. I'm going to glue inside here a little bit. So I'm just basically sticking the brush down towards the point there to get a bit of glue on the inside. And then I'm going to apply some glue to the sort of top of the cone section here. We'll let those sit a second and then we'll join that together. And what we want to do is we want to get the seam here, which is running down the back, also aligned with where we've decided it's the back. So we've got everything that's going to look like the back on the back. So when this goes in, where we've made those two marks that we decided on earlier, get the seam there, and then you're just going to have to work that on up in there, get that shoved in, and then just have a look and try and make sure it looks even. Make sure you've got it pushed in the same amount all the way around, so lay it flat and just twist it round. Make sure it doesn't look too lopsided. Then that should be fine. So put your finger up on the inside there, give that a little bit of a squeeze, just to get that glue to grab up at the top there. It's never really going to come undone at all. And then the final thing to do is to just join those two pieces together. So we've already got those two marks there. So again, take your awl, don't stick it in your finger, and just push through there to the inside. And through there, so we're going right the way through. And then again, we're just going to want to loop that round. So all I'm going to do is take a little bit of that thread that I had earlier. And I'm only going to do this just with one needle because it's essentially just a little kind of a tack almost. Okay, so I'm going to come from the inside to the outside and get that in there. I'll leave the tail of the thread on the inside. And then all we're going to do is just whip this round a couple of times. Again, it's very unlikely to ever try and come apart. So that'll be the third time there. So we'll pass that thread through back to the inside. So we end up with two tails on the inside. Pull that snug. Snip those off on the inside. We'll just leave a few millimetres of thread on the inside as well to stop that pulling through. And then that's all we've got. Look, it's just a tiny little tack there just to keep the top and the bottom. In case anybody starts pulling at this, just keeps that in one place. Okay, there we are, that's the little tree complete. I'll put a picture on the video, make it easier to see because you're looking down on it. But it should stand up on its base okay. Just makes a little ornament there that you can pop on a mantelpiece or something like that, and it's just a little bit of fun really. As I say, you can decorate these however you want. You can do a red base instead of a sort of wooden base, you can do different types of patterns on here. You don't have to put the things on. You could get some acrylic paint and draw some little presents on or something like that. And if you don't want to have it stood on its bottom like that as well, you can simply take an awl, make a hole through the top part here where we haven't got any stitching, pass some thread through, and then you can make that so there's some thread on the top like that. In other words, so it's going through, and then you can easily then have this hanging as an ornament, you know, hanging off your Christmas tree, a mini tree hanging on your tree if you want to. You can do whatever you want with it, it's just an idea. So obviously if you want to make a bigger one than this, you can as well. That's come out to, it's about 10 centimetres high, it's just a little mini tree. If you want to make a bigger one, all you need to do when you print the pattern, look at your printing options, look at the bit that says scaling, and change it so it says like 150% or 200%, something like that. Print your pieces out, everything will scale, and then you can obviously just have a bigger tree if you want to. But the idea with these is really that it's just a little mini tree. Okay, so I hope you've enjoyed that video. There may be one more video from me before Christmas. If I get it done, I'm not sure. If not, I will be back in the new year. I've got probably 6 or 8 videos planned that I know what I want to do next year. So I'll try and get those out as regularly as I can. But as you know, it's been difficult, so they'll just appear as and when. Okay, so if I'm not back for another video before Christmas, then have a good Christmas, and I'll see you next year.